Claude Julien's Montreal Canadiens can't score. Just four goals so far. So the Leafs have scored 22, but they've given up 16. There is simply no better place to be for a hockey fan on Saturday night. Here's the talented Udon, 23-year-old from Alma, Quebec. A long shot by Davidson. Nice save there by Frederick Anderson. And the Canadiens break out through center. Here's Drouin again, number 92. Passes back, the long shot by Petrie. He scores! Another early lead. Jeff Petrie with a shot at 2 minutes, 19 seconds, 1-0 Montreal.
Well, Jeff, coaches will always tell players that good defensive positioning can create offense, and that's exactly what happened here. He had a good, solid breakout. Entry into the zone, back the D off, and talk about breaking the dam for Petrie. His first goal in 52 games through a crowd.
Straight up the middle, Byron, give and go. Byron, great save by Anderson. Gallagher and Byron look like they've come to play tonight. And the Leafs get a chance to move up the middle. Bozak to Van Riemsdyk with some room in front. Mitch Marner, stopped by Price. Where's the puck? Still loose, and it's underneath him.
And then right off the faceoff here, Jim, a real surprise.
James Van Riemsdyk, right off a faceoff, beats Carey Price and ties it up after he made the terrific play to Mitch Marner. Off the attacking zone faceoff, he ties the game.
And this is just a bit of a fluke play. Watch where this puck ends up. It goes right into neutral area, but hits the skate of Lehkonen. You can see his reaction looking skyward. And, Jim, that's sometimes where you're just not even how much he got on that puck. That one barely made it over the line as it hit Petrie in front.
Matthews knocked the puck out of the air. Snaps a shot. He scores. Wow. What a shot. Austin Matthews quickly makes this 2-1 Toronto.
Well, you can give an assist to Kadri there, but wow, what a goal and an amazing individual effort. Matthews wouldn't even be on the ice had it not been for the injury to Kadri. Anderson with a quick pass. Matthews grabs it, chips it to an area, catches Ben, knocks it out of midair, and a curl and drag, an absolute fire past the glove of Carey Price.
On the icing, Matthews comes on, wins the draw. Gardner shot that one off the base of the post.
It was far and wide.
Charles Hudon in the second unit. 2-on-1. Galchenyuk shoots. He scores! That'll be a relief. First power play goal of the season. The first goal for Alex Galchenyuk. 2-2 tie.
And Jim, you look at his teammates and what their reaction is. They know what that goal means. It's not just a goal that ties the game, but maybe gets a monkey off his back. That all-important first one. This is an awfully close play at the line. Is there any chance it's offside? Nah, looked like it was all right. We saw Matthews with the quick wrister, and there's another one at the other end as Galchenyuk pounces on that loose puck, looks off a pass quickly, and 14 inches stick side.
And you know Matt Martin's right there. Here's a 2-on-1 on a Leaf change. Galchenyuk shoots, reaching in with Zach Hyman to get a little piece of that. Nylander turns. Matthews on the other side. They go to the front of the net. Marlowe banging away out of his Connor Brown tried to get him the puck from in front of the net because he was in tight to the goaltender. So Udon comes back the other way. Andrew Shaw leaves him the puck backhanded to the net. Anderson pulls it out of the air on the rebound. With Shaw trying to bat at it. Zaitsev up the boards, off the bench. Davidson with a shot. Walked into that right off the bench, and Anderson made the save. Here's Jake Gardner. Nylander takes over, trying to get away from Brendan Gallagher. Backhands the puck to the net. A backhand shot knocked out of the air by Matthews. No goal. Waved off right away. Matthews knocked it out of the air, and the Leafs aren't celebrating right now. They'll have to have a look at this.
Yeah, this was a real close play that you saw the reaction of Carey Price. He was trying to track that, and the coaching staff watching the replay as quick as they can. They're going to have another look at it just to determine, and that's rightly so. But how about Nylander? Just the patience with the puck, pulls it around, gets it to the front of the net. It goes Hyman, and boy, that's not high stick, is it there?
He hit it twice.
The referee behind the net was absolutely emphatic there as John McIsaac had no hesitation.
Face off sideline. After video review, the call on the ice stands. It's no goal.
Juarez lying on the ice. Easy. And Morgan Riley playing against them. That's kept in by Osler. Score! Jonathan Drouin has his first goal as a Montreal Canadian.
Riley tries to get it out. Along the boards, Pacioretty keeps it in along with Osler. And how about that heads-up play? You've got traffic in front that makes it very difficult for Anderson to hit. But look at that quick curl back, stick on the ice. Drouin just going hard to the net and just a perfect deflection up and over the glove of Frederick Anderson.
Marlow. Kadri leaves for Komarov. Wrap around, places down, puck is loose. Kadri tried to poke it in, Marlow did too. Patrick Marlow acted like he scored, but this is waved off by Kelly Sutherland.
Kelly Sutherland is right on the doorstep there. Boy, the officials have been in the right place at the right time. Once again, Babcock looking down. And how about the night for Carey Price? Some anxious moments around the battle behind the net, the quick wraparound. I don't think Price thought that Komarov was there, and then a nice job of not having a quick whistle. I thought for a second that did look like it might have gone off over the line.
Video shows the puck completely crossing the line before the play is dead. Therefore, we have a good goal.
He's passed to Plekanec. Nylander trying to get back. Plekanec to the net. Nice save by Anderson. Rebound shot wide by Gallagher. Protects the puck, threw it off the goaltender. Jordy Benn with his shot, and somehow through all of that traffic, Anderson found the puck again. Plekanec from Gallagher. Gallagher again. Plekanec shoots, and Anderson makes the save and stops playing. Marlowe's there to try and help it. Petrie trying to recover in a battle with Kadri. Komarov, side of the net, hit the outside of the post. Fought to the front of the net, and now to Brandon Davidson on the other side. Jordy Benn screenshot, tip by shot. Anderson's down, and he grabbed onto the puck before Andrew Shaw could tuck it in on the second chance. Deneau right on him in a hurry, got the puck back to the blue line. Hot shot by Brandon Davidson. Allsner in a little trouble. He's got lots of help. Now the puck is loose in front of the net. Price is down on top of it. Shaw knocked away by Gardner to Zaitsev coming off the bench. Here's Marner, fires a shot. Kadri got him the puck coming off the bench, and Price made his best save of the third period. To Nylander, tips it in, and this game is headed for sudden death overtime. Here's a chance for a two-on-one. Paul Byron with Plekanec. Can't get much of a shot away. They almost got a bounce into the net. Nylander end of his shift, but here comes again to Austin Matthews. He shoots, he scores! And for the first time in 15 games, the Toronto Maple Leafs have defeated the Montreal Canadiens, and it's another special shot from Austin Matthews that wins the game.
Boy, a pretty special player, isn't he? He's starting to write some great storylines in his young career, following up on the Calder.
And it's a 4-3 Toronto win.
And that showed beautifully there, just the quickness of the release. It's for Carey Price thinking, seeing that rolling puck, that he's going to maybe take a second or two. Instead, it's on the tape, off the tape, and it's not necessarily the strength of the shot. It's the positioning that counts.
That's why you work out all summer, so that the end of a 48-second shift with back-checking involved, you still got some gas in the tank to go on the attack and score a goal.